Ladies and gentlemen, I am Brock Beard, and this is your starting lineup as they have qualified for the Showtime Southern 500 at Darlington. On the pole for the first time this year, his fourth at Darlington, and a new track record of over 181 miles per hour. Give it to Casey Citizen Kane. Starting second, ready for revenge after tangling with Montoya at Richmond with the fastest car in practice, the Rocket Man 2003 pole sitter Ryan Newman. Row 2, the defending winner of this race, Denny Hammer and Hamlin in the Sport Clips Toyota, and it's black, it quacks, it is sponsored by Aflac, the 99, a point leader, Concrete Carl Edwards, welcomed his second child into the world on Friday. Row 3, the Wonder Boy, 7-time winner Jeff Gordon, ready to go after that 40G crash at Richmond. The Tasmanian Devil, Marcus Ambrose, has really turned around his speedway program this year. Row 4, dangerous AJ Allmendinger, qualified right behind his teammate, and the Red Bulldozer, Brian Vickers, 10th here last year. Row 5, the Rushville Rocket, Tony Stewart, looking for his first win at the Lady in Black, and Brad, the Big Keselowski, his third top 10 start of the year. Row 6 has Car 6 to the Amaze, and David Reagan, who's on the inside of defending pole sitter, runner-up, and former track record holder, Jamie McMurray from Joplin, Missouri. Row 7, the closer, Kevin Harvick, just one top 10 finish in his last 7 Darlington starts, and the Wild Thing, 2008 winner, last week's race winner, and last night's Nationwide Series winner, Kyle Busch, scraped the wall in practice, but runs the same car tonight. Row 8, Corpus Christi's Bobby Labonte in the patriotic number 47, and the Destroyer, Juan Pablo Montoya, 5th last year. Row 9, Slice Bread himself, Joey Logano, 9th at Richmond, and the bright yellow fella, Paul Menard in the Turtle Wax Chevrolet. Row 10, a 2-time Darlington winner, Jimmy Johnson in the 40 Dominate, and Texas winner, Mighty Matt Kenseth, took the pole 2 years ago. Back in row 11, scoring his best start of the season, Full Throttle Travis Quapel is tops among the go-or-go-homers. And in 22nd, it is the Biffmeister, 2005 and 2006 winner, Greg Biffle. Row 12, Sleek and Swift, Regan Smith qualifies outside the top 20 for the first time this season, but starts next to the mayor, 2-time Darlington winner, Jeff Burton. Row 13, in a backup car following this hard hit into the turn 1 wall after he cut a right front tire, the double deuce of Kurt Busch won his first cup pole here in 2001. The warrior from Emporia, Clint Boyers, hits 7th in points. Row 14, Landon Sandcastle in the Thank a Teacher Chevrolet, and the Mark 5 of 2-time pole and race winner, Mark Martin. Row 15, the new Jersey Fury, Martin Truex Jr. has some new crew members tonight, and fan favorite Dale Earnhardt Jr. has finished 18th and 27th in his last two starts at Darlington. Row 16, J.J. Yaley for Dusty Whitney, and Casey Mears reappears in 32nd, but comes into this race tied with both the 32 and 71 teams for that coveted 35th spot in owner points. Row 17, bouncing off the wall but solidly in the show for his first ever Sprint Cup start, for whom the bell tolls, it tolls for T. Give a call to T.J. Bell, giving Joe Falk his first Cup start since the fall race at Richmond 11 years ago. Joining Bell is the principal, Mike Skinner. Row 18, Tony, have you ever seen the reins for Larry Gunselman? And Hoodaman, David Rudaman. Row 19, David Gilliland in the Taco Bell Ford. And 38th spot is the scene of the crime for Inception Motorsports' second consecutive start with David Stremme. Row 20, also for the second straight race, the Texas Twister, Michael McDowell, and the HP Racing team have enough sponsorship from K-Love to run all night. Super K, 3-time pole sitter Kenny Schrader, makes his 44th Cup start at Darlington behind the wheel of Frankie Stoddard's number 32. Row 21, the Buckeye Bullet, Dave Blaney in the Golden Corral, top 10 Kids Eat Free Chevrolet, and the Fast 5 Dodge of Robbie Gordon. And in row 22, all by himself, front row Joe Nemechek has yet to miss a race all year. Three teams did miss the race, however. Scotty Riggs, in the return of Dusty Whitney's second team, saw his run go up in smoke when the engine blew after his first timed lap. Road racer Andy Lally misses his first race of 2011 after he smacked the wall during his qualifying lap. And Brian the Bull Keselowski is still searching for his team's first start since Bristol. In addition, Derek Cope withdrew on Thursday when the engine on his Maxcellence energy drink Chevrolet did not have enough power. Cope's team converted from Dodge to Chevrolet and is hoping to return to the track in the sprint showdown. And ladies and gentlemen, there's your field for the Showtime Southern 500 at Darlington.